Android 5.0 Key Lime Pie seems to already be on the test bench. AT&T will allow one replacement of your water-damaged Galaxy S4 active, and Apple will buy back your fake charger due to electrocution complaints. I'm Jaime Rivera, and it seems that electrocution is the new thing in smartphones lately. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with the hot news. For those of you waiting for the blue variant of the HTC One, we finally get some press renders, so it's only a matter of time, probably IFA in Berlin. And for those of you that were doubting about the HTC One Max leak photos that we saw yesterday, well, we got some more photos, and this time it's being compared to this 4-inch Motorola phone. And yeah, that One Max is big, really big. Now let's talk about Apple. First of all, developers have now received iOS 7 Beta 5, which some confirm is much faster and more stable than it was before. I can't really tell the difference. But on the other hand, well, Apple has now issued a new USB wall adapter take-back program for any of you that have a fake wall charger or a third-party wall charger and want to swap it. It'll cost you $10 at any Apple store, and they'll give you a new, genuine Apple wall adapter for the fake one that you have. And, well, it's kind of cool to have this is after all the electrocution complaints that happened in China, which were only two. So can you imagine all those fake Chinese iPhones getting electrocuted as well? Hurry up. Speaking of product replacements, after all the controversy of these Samsung Galaxy S4 Actives drowning instead of actually withstanding their active abilities to be waterproof, well, AT&T has now confirmed that they will be replacing your Galaxy S4 Active one time if you can prove that the device was not damaged in any other way that's not water damaged. So for those of you that have that problem right now, hurry up. Now, an interesting leak from the Chromium project reveals that there is this developer that's currently testing a version of Android that starts with a K. And for those of you that know, builds of Android start with the letter of the version of Android that's currently out. So it's J for Jelly Bean and K would be Key Lime Pie. So yes, Key Lime Pie is currently on the test bench, and it begs to wonder, I mean, it's currently being tested on a Nexus 4 and the Nexus 7. Could it be that whenever we get the future generation Nexus, we'll also get the future version of Android? Stay tuned. And finally, for the hot news of the day, tomorrow is finally the LG G2 event. This is probably one of the worst kept secrets in the mobile industry, and it finally gets announced tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern time, so please join us in our live hangout. We'll be starting our hangout at the same time that the event happens, so everything that gets announced will give you our first impressions and just about everything you need to know, and our own Michael Fisher will also be live at the event, so expect all our hands-on videos, all our comparison videos, and all our first impressions of this phone as it gets announced at 11 a.m. Eastern. Please join our hangout. And, well, that leads me to the question of the day. Are you waiting for this LG G2? Is this a phone that you want? In my particular case, yes, I do want this phone, but I want that future version of the Nexus smartphone more, which is will be based off this G2, so stay tuned and join our hangout. Of course, you know the drill. For an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tech world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow for our live coverage of the LG G2 event.